Well, welcome back to the channel. We are...
This is a test of the Corona broadcast system.
We are officially in Corona lockdown mode. Been working at home for about a week, a little less than a week. And really, I guess there's nothing better to do than to just get some work done here on the guitar. So, in this episode, I'm going to be working on the Rosette. And I'm going to get you a little closer here. So I've got here a walnut rosette with two small rings, one on the inside, one on the outside, and it's going to complement the guitar pretty well, I think, because the back of the guitar has a center strip of walnut down it, so this will be a good accent piece for it. And basically what I've done is I have my Dremel with the Stumac circle cutting jig, and I've done a couple practice runs. You know, they give you the pin, you drill a little hole in the center, and it's just basically like a circle cutting jig. I've got actually a kind of an expensive, these things aren't cheap for some reason, but it's a down cutting router bit as opposed to just like a carbide tip flush cutting type bit or something like that. So I'm using that bit, and I did a couple practice runs trying to get the fit just right, and I think I got it here on this one. It's pretty good, not that much gap at all really on the edge. It fits in there pretty tight, and I've the outer rings, they come similar to this, sort of bigger than you actually need it, and I spent some time fitting it, took a chisel, trimmed it down to size with the chisel, and then took a little sanding block and would just sort of like sand the end of it so I had a nice flat edge. Took the burr off, so to speak, as well. That took a bit of time, but it's fitting pretty nice now. So what I'm gonna do is I have my top, my soundboard, I'll put that up there for now. I have that right here. It's already been sized, glued up. I've used my template to trace out the perimeter here at the top. I've got the sound hole. And what I'll just need to do is drill my center hole. And, you know, go for it, basically. I'm gonna use this jig that I glued the top on together with. I use this jig to kind of secure it, put my pin into the jig, and hopefully I don't make any mistakes, because I only get one shot at this, and I don't want to mess it up. Alright, so let's get to it. All right, so I have my acrylic template here for my guitar top. And I want to just make sure I got a nice clean line for the sound hole. And I need to mark the center.
find the center here. This neat little rule. It's a center finding rule. Try to do that. It looks like it's about inch and 15/16. That should be the center. Right. Double check that. Inch and 15/16. Inch and 15/16. That is the center, right on the seam. So this particular jig uses a pin, and I think it's 11/64. Yeah, 11/64 drill bit. Now we will now very important that we are square. So this hole needs to be drilled very square. Plumb and square. I'm gonna use this square as a guide. Put the tip on it. Okay. Use this just as a guide. I'm going to go in reverse just a couple turns. That'll help make a pilot hole right where I need it. Alright. So I want to pull out, I need to pull out this rosette that I had in here. Just using a pick to do that. Because I'm going to use this channel that I routed as a guide to route, set up the circle cutting jig to route the top. Just going to carefully get this out without breaking it. Because Lord knows nothing can get delivered during the coronavirus panic. Alright, so that's the outside. And then you can see the inside one, it fit pretty well, so it is staying in there. Might be hard to see, but it's in there. Alright. Just gonna make a couple pencil marks so I don't mess up and I know exactly which channel to use as a guide. Alright, so I just put a dowel in here just so I can mount this, because I'm gonna need to use this to check my depth and my actual radius. And so I can't go that deep. So my top is about 85 thousandths thick. So I probably can only go about 50 thousandths deep with my channel, whereas my test, I probably went closer to 100 thou deep, and I can't do that. So I'm just gonna lower the bit ever so slightly and take really some really small passes. All right, but so I've got the bit raised up almost all the way, and I'm gonna just adjust this to the outside. I'm gonna lock that in there, I think. And let's set the depth to not very much. Set it to there. Alright, here goes nothing.
Things I notice. You see how I went both ways? It creates a bit of not tear out so much as just like a burr almost in the wood. So going around one way and then the opposite way seems to help remove some of that. I also make sure there's no tension on this extension on this cord, because it seems to kind of pull the Dremel out of plumb, and I noticed on some of my test cuts it was really kind of making the circle not so circular. So so it looks close. I don't think I'm gonna really set the inside depth and then make a pass there without changing the depth of the cut yet. So I'm just real nervous. You also don't want to get sawdust underneath the jig, because it'll obviously change elevation of everything. Move this back. Go with there for now. 32nd, maybe 16th at the most, and make another pass. Just gonna try to plow out whatever's left. Definitely not deep enough. Take my gauge here, my caliper. I got a little ways to go still. Close. I'm gonna finish the channel, and if that if it fits in there well, then I might not go any deeper. I do like this. This circle cutting jig. I just wish that this rule that they have on here, the directions say it's just really for reference only. If they could redesign it so that this is an accurate, I know that, you know, maybe it's with different size bits, it's hard to do that, but it'd be nice if you could just dial it in to a measurement right on the jig, rather than having to sort of eye it up like this, because you just lose a little bit of accuracy from doing it this way. Sound hole, because I think that's where you'll notice it the least. I'm just going to fit in this other one. The Corona email. Get this all set in here. This looks a little
here's the seam for the inner and outer ring. Obviously the center walnut ring does not have any seam at all. It's a
chat right there, right? Could be a shot holding it up. Enough clamping pressure, and we'll let that dry for a good 3-4 hours, and we'll come back, scrape and sand, and cut out the sound hole. All Irwin Quick Grip, not a sponsor. Let's show the wife, huh? Morning, everyone. It's the next day. And let's do a little sanding. 120 grit. Try and flatten this out a little bit, nice and gently. Everyone's freaking out, including myself, about this coronavirus stuff. We're about a week in. I just want to get back to normal. Just like before, I want to leave this line, depending on the inside of the line, and I'm going to leave it, and I want to raise the blade up a bit. Alright, let's take a little sandpaper here. Next video, we will work on the bracing, gluing the bracing on, and then that'll the next video after that, we glue the top onto the sides. So, appreciate everyone watching. Like, comment, and subscribe, and stay healthy, and we'll see y'all next time.